Hey everybody, it's Dana. Welcome back to my YouTube channel and blog. Today I'm still working on fall cards because like I said, it's my favorite season of the year. So let's go ahead and get started. I have some Nina Solarite 80-pound cardstock and I'm going to be grabbing those texture leaves stamp set from Hero Arts. Now if you guys missed the card I made earlier last week, you can go ahead and watch it right here. I'll put the link up here and then I'll also put the link in the description box. So I'm just lining those up using my Misti, and I'm gonna grab one more and place that down. Now for my inks today, I wanna use something a little bit different. And I haven't played with these inks for a while, so I'm glad I'm using them again. So I'm using the Hero Arts Ombre ink pads. I have these in several shades and I absolutely love them. And I don't know why they're sitting on my shelf and I have not used them. So for today's card, I'm going to break them out and give them some love. So what's really cool about these ombre ink pads is that you get a variety of color out of one ink pad. You have like little stripes of color. And when you stamp, as you can see here, I'm getting a great variations of greens without having to use multiple ink pads to achieve that look. The next color I'm going to use goes from a orangey color to a yellow color. Now this leaf is kind of small, but I'm going to be able to get a little bit of that variation on there. And how I stamp them is I just kind of press the ink pad kind of around a little bit so I can get full color of the variation, I should say, of color. Now I did miss a little bit of the middle of this, so I'm going to go back in and re-stamp that one just so I have a full image. Now usually in nature, as we all know, when leaves dry out, they get kind of, they break up a little bit. So you might have some open areas. And that's what I love about these textured leaves, because you really get the texture of a actual leaf in these stamp sets. So for that leaf right there, I used the ombre in red tones. And now for my last leaf, I'm going to use the ombre that has brown tones in it. So I'm just going to go ahead and kind of dance that across the stamp just to get some color built up. Now, again, what's so great about using my Misti, if I have missed an area, I can go back and re-stamp that. So I am going to re-stamp this one right here just because I want a little bit more definition in this image. So I'm going to go ahead and press that down and I'm just going to rub on it this time. All right, so now I have all of my beautiful leaves done. Now my last card, I did not use the coordinating dies, but for this card I am. So as you can see, they were still in the package and I'm just going to use my wire snippers to go ahead and snip these apart. Now what's so beautiful about this stamp set is you can fussy cut these out if you don't have the dies, because they're really easy images to cut out. But I ended up purchasing the dies this time just to make that a little bit easier for myself. Now, since I have all of the images or the dies cut apart, I can go ahead and I always use a little bit of washi tape just to hold my dies in place. Sometimes they like to shift around and I don't want to ruin these beautiful leaves. So now since I have everything with the coordinating die around it, I'm going to go ahead and run this through my die cut machine. Now I did stamp these images a couple more times because I wanted to fill up my card panel. Now I'm not going to leave it white. I'm going to use some fossilized amber and my makeup brush. And I'm just going to blend on some of this color. I'm going to have the color darker around the corners, and then it will gradually go lighter towards the center. Now I like using this technique, especially if I'm going to be using a sentiment. I really don't want the sentiment to be on a really dark area. And this just gives me the opportunity to have a little bit of a highlight down the middle of my card. So now I'm not going to ink it up anymore. I'm just going to take the residue that's left on my makeup brush and kind of just fill in that center area. And that gives me a nice focal point to the middle of my card. And as you can see, this brush holds a lot of ink. All right, so now I have my little highlight in the center and now I'm ready to go. Now I'm gonna come in and I'm just going to temporarily place down these leaves. Now, the good thing about having them die cut out is that I can stack one of them on top of the other without really losing the color part. So I'm just playing around with a little bit of a variation of how I want these images to sit on my card. Some of them will hang off the side, some of them will be more on the card. I'm not trying to get each section the same, because if you were throwing up leaves and they all landed, they wouldn't place the same. So I'm going to give myself a little bit of artistry in this. And now I'm going to go ahead and grab a sentiment. Now, I did have the Hero Arts Kit of the Month, and I used the sentiment for my last card out of this one here. So I'm just going to grab that thankful, and I'm going to place that right between the leaves. Now, having my leaves sitting on my card gives me the opportunity to figure out where I want that sentiment so it's not covered up by the leaves in the end. So I'm just going to make sure that's where I want it. I think that looks good and even. And now I can go ahead and grab my Misty and line this up. So I'm just going to pick up everything very carefully and set that into my Misty. Now, I do want to remove the leaves when I go to stamp out my sentiment because I don't want them to get inked up. So I'm going to go ahead and remove them now because now I know my sentiment is where I need it to be. And I'm just going to go ahead and swing over that lid and then grab some ink. Now, I am going to use, I kind of debated on what ink, if I wanted brown or black, but I decided to go with the black instead. So I'm using a VersaFine Black Onyx ink, and I'm going to go ahead and tap that down. And I'm going to stamp it one more time because I really want this image or this sentiment to be really bold. That looks perfect. And now we can go ahead and move on to assembling the card. Now again, I do know that my sentiment is exactly where it needs to be. And now I'm just going to line back up where my leaves were. Again, I don't have to be perfect doing this because, again, if we were in nature and we just saw a bunch of leaves, it wouldn't be perfectly placed. So I'm just setting them back up so I know that it frames out that sentiment. And again, I'm going to have some hanging off the card. I'm going to have some just laying on the card. And I like the definition of that arrangement. So for the leaves underneath, I'm going to use my Nuvo adhesive for this. Some of these leaves I want to have popped up, and the other ones I just want to have flat on my card. So I'm just going to add some of that glue and then place down my leaves again. So I'm just going to tap that into place, and then I can go ahead and move on to the next one. Now, each one of these, I'm just going to make sure that I put enough adhesive on here so it really sticks to the back of my card, or rather to my card panel. Now, since I have that in place, I want to go ahead and pop up my other two leaves. So for this, I'm just going to grab myself some foam squares and allow some of these images to be a little bit raised off that card panel. Now, I could have put them all flat, but I wanted to have a little bit of dimension in my card. So I'm just going to grab about four of those and place those right onto the back. Now, what's so beautiful about these leaves is you can do them in a variety of colors and then just change out the background. So you can make this background a gray color. You can make it more of a fall look and maybe put down light coats of brown. So just changing out the background of this can really change the look of your card. So for that last leaf, I'm just going to tuck that under the green one. And I'm also going to have this one raised up a little bit. So I'm going to use, again, some of those foam dots or foam squares and place this one on so this one has a little bit of definition as well. So just need to peel off the backs, and then I can nestle in this one right underneath that green one. And now I have a really nice arrangement on the bottom of my card. So I'm going to go ahead and repeat that process across the top of my card. Again, I'm just going to use some liquid adhesive on some of these and then the pop-up squares on some of the green one and the brown one to give it some dimension. Again, I'm just laying out my leaves. Again, I'm not trying to match the ones that are on the bottom. I just want to have them laid on there, and then anything that hangs over the edge, I can trim out a little bit later. All right, I really like how that looks, so I'm just going to remove the top two, and again, put the bottom ones on with that liquid adhesive. So I'm just going to go ahead and get all of these lined up on my card and just place and stack them so I can see each one of my leaves. All right, now I can just add on the last leaf here. Again, the green one has been popped up as well on the foam squares. And I can nestle this one in to the corner. All right, now my card panel is done. I'm not gonna add anything else to this because I think the leaves really do the job of what I want, a really nice fall card. I'm gonna grab in my Nina Solar White 110-pound card base, and now I can go ahead and adhere this top panel to this. Now, again, you can see some of these leaves are hanging off the side of my card, but that's okay because I'm going to be able to trim that down a little bit later. I'm going to line that up right onto that card base and then go ahead and press that down in place. Now, look how gorgeous this card is. And again, if you change up the colors, you'll totally get different looks with this. Now, since I have that on there, I'm going to go ahead and grab my scissors to cut off anything that is hanging off the sides. So these are my tonic trimmers or tonic scissors, and I'm just gonna trim off whatever is hanging off the side of the card. And this is super easy to do when you have a great pair of scissors. Just trim off the rest of that, and then our card is done. What a beautiful fall card. All right, everybody, thanks so much for hanging out with me today. Here is the total card done. Thanks so much. Please make sure if you like this video to give me a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in another video soon. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.